Okay, last page. So simplifying an expression, remember our usual method is to just make everything in terms of sine and cosine and then simplify as much as possible. So so I'll just jump right into this one. The cosecant, of course, is 1 over sine of x, and the cotangent is cosine of x over sine of x. So the part that's in parentheses here is now just this stuff written in terms of sine and cosine. And then I still am multiplying by 1 plus cosine x. So another nice thing about this problem is that we already have a common denominator with the fraction, so we don't have that work to do. So I can just write the first thing as 1 minus cosine x over sine x. And then that's still multiplied by 1 plus cosine x. So now the second thing I'm multiplying by is really just like having that over 1, so I'm going to multiply the numerator, multiply the denominator. When you multiply the numerators, you're going to be using FOIL, but you may notice the form there. It's a plus b times a minus b, that form. And so we've been seeing that more, you know, over and over again. It just means the outer and inner terms are going to cancel each other out. But what I have by doing FOIL is 1 minus cosine squared of x. And the denominator is still just sine of x. One of my Pythagorean identities says that 1 minus cosine squared is the same thing as sine squared. And so now this thing simplifies quite a bit, because sine squared over sine x is just sine x. The last two problems are just word problems. The number 4 is just like one that we did on the homework. We're talking about a point on a graph of cosine, so the cosine graph looks kind of like this, and that's pi over 2 right there. So we're being told in the problem that we only want to consider values of x between 0 and pi over 2, so that's our domain. So my point has to be here. If I label that in terms of x, the x-coordinate will be called x, and the y-coordinate will just be given by the formula for the function, so that'll be 4 cosine x. So now if I draw the rest of this rectangle in here, I can label the width of this rectangle by thinking about how far apart they are. The x-coordinate on the right is x, the x-coordinate on the other side is negative x, so the width here is 2x, and then the height of this rectangle is just given by the y-coordinate, 4 cosine x. So my area function is base times height, which will be 2x times 4 cosine x. And it probably makes sense to write that as 8x cosine x before putting it in my calculator. You want to make sure we have our calculator on radian mode. We're always working in radians when we're working with the graphs of the functions. So anytime we're drawing a graph, the x axis is always labeled using the x's in radians. So make sure that your calculator is in radian mode before you draw the picture. But if you do that, you'll find that the maximum area occurs at x approximately 0.86. And that's all we were asking to do in this problem, is find the value of x that gives us the largest rectangle. So that would be drawing a picture where x is 0.86. Okay, last problem is a folding up a piece of paper problem, which we did in class. But the one we did in class had a square piece of paper, and this is an actual real piece of paper, an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper that we're used to using for things. So if we fold an 8.5 by 11 piece of paper up into a box shape, we'll get this sort of tray-looking thing, and I can label the sides 8x, I mean the height x, the width this way, 8.5 inches minus 2x, and the dimensions this way, 11 minus 2x. So if you forget how those dimensions come from the original picture, look at the original worksheet that we did, and you'll see the piece of paper before it's folded, and then you can usually tell what's happened here. So if we use that, then our volume is just going to be the product of those three things. And I'll add the domain here. The domain is just the values of x that make none of those three dimensions negative, so I need to have the x's being positive for sure, and then I want to go no bigger than 4 1/4, because if I went bigger than 4 1/4 for x, then this dimension would be negative. So I can go all the way up to 4.25 without making anything negative. So this is the function that I'm focused on. I want to draw that on my calculator. I'd made a picture of this earlier. Let me just grab it off the computer here. So here's the picture that I drew of this function, and you can see that the maximum point's going to occur somewhere up there. If I put that in my calculator, the function over the window, I'll get that the maximum volume box can be made when you use a 1.59-inch square. So in other words, if you cut a normal piece of paper, cut a 1.59-inch square out of each corner and fold it up, what you'll get is a volume of approximately 66.2 cubic inches. So that's the biggest box that you can make folding up the sides of a normal piece of paper.